giant glass facades. Sheet glass and large glass windows have proliferated across the country over the last 50, 60 years quite dramatically. Ironically, I think this is intended to make people feel closer to nature and that they can, you know, see out and see the birds and see the trees and see everything outside. Sadly, it turns out that it has some devastating consequences for birds. Over 1 billion birds are estimated to die every year in North America due to building collisions, and some estimates indicate that that number may even be much higher than that. So the Yale Bird-Friendly Building Initiative is to try to accelerate both the development and adoption of bird-friendly building design at scale, both on Yale's campus and beyond. Most birds can't see most glass. They either perceive transparent glass as not being a surface, so they can fly straight through it, or glass that is highly reflective of habitat creates an optical illusion. And so that became the sort of first tenet of the project, gathering substantial data with the help of teams of undergraduate and graduate student research assistants.
So in the 2 years that we've actually done this systematically with the Planetary Solutions funding, we actually found already recorded over 2,600 casualties. We actually realized that it was quite a high diversity of species, over 70 species involved, and some species represented by over 100 individuals. And we actually even found some species that were of conservation concern.
And then we've taken that data and we've created quite extensive maps showing exactly where on campus these collisions are occurring. It's an entirely fixable problem. We have an ever-growing range of products that can be applied both to new buildings and existing buildings. Commonly what's done is a window film or decals are put on the outside of the window. We've succeeded so far in a number of ways. The Tobin Center where we're sitting is one example of a building that Yale made bird safe from the start. All of the windows to the exterior have a ceramic frit embedded in them, which means that they're visible to birds from the outside. The new Yale Peabody Museum is another example. And then there are several buildings that we identified through our study that have been killing large number of birds that have also been either fully or partially retrofitted. At the Collection Study Center on Yale's West Campus, for example, we had hundreds of birds hit in a single season. When the window film, which is called Kaleidoscape, was added to the building, the number of collisions the next migration season went nearly to zero. We also have published a long report called Building Safer Cities for Birds that reviews all of the bird-friendly building policies that have been implemented in U.S. cities to date and provides a wide range of recommendations and a roadmap for other cities that may want to follow suit.
It's really heartwarming when we actually see some of these building managers adopt some of our recommendations and making a difference. We already see fewer birds dying. For us, bird people, ornithologists, the role of birds the value is very obvious.
They are spreading seeds, that they're taking care of carrion, they're moving nutrients, and the sheer beauty that they contribute to the city, all of which we would be, you know, so impoverished to lose.